Hello all, welcome to General Awareness for Computer Exams in English. So basically this is your master class for General Awareness number 2. Those who didn't see the master class number 1, you can check the playlist, okay? And obviously in the respective playlist of your exam, you will get this class if it is important for you, okay? So today we will see, and one more request from you guys, so I will consider that request, and again little modification in our this series now, okay? So I will tell you. So basically those who reading the current affair from our website as per our plan, okay, daily current affair, so those students while making notes have a problem, okay, and they don't know that which point should they write in the notes, and that is actually a valid point because all these things are there, and from that you just need to filter out the things and you have to write, okay? So now after our session of general awareness, okay, each day we will do daily summary of current affairs, okay? So summary of daily current affairs we will do in the last of this session. In that I will tell you which current affair are important of today, okay, and which is not. So likewise you can write in your notes, okay? So this modification we are doing to our session. Now let's continue our session from question number 5. Already we saw question number 4 questions in the last class. So question number 5, how many Lok Sabha seats come from Tamil Nadu? So 43, 29, 39 and 34, okay? So for this your answer is 39. Now listen carefully, this is very important topic, that polity, okay? This question is from polity, parliament. So on this special general knowledge session tomorrow morning I will upload, okay, in the GK playlist. The playlist name is GK, okay? I will link that in your respective exam playlist. So because see, this is very important topic, and you can see or you can expect this question in TCS, IBPS, okay, any exam agency, conducting agency. So that's why separate session on this we will discuss in detail whatever the points are important for you, okay, whether TCS is asking, depending on this particular pattern I will mention it, okay? So now the thing is that just a few points let's just discuss. So maximum Lok Sabha seat is from Uttar Pradesh, okay, and that is your 80, and then it is from Maharashtra, and for Maharashtra I guess 38 or 39, okay, 38 I guess. So maximum Uttar Pradesh, okay, and Maharashtra 38. And one more thing, if you have any of your exam, okay, of state exam, then you should know Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha seats of your state, okay, if you have any exam. So remember your state, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha seats, okay? And tomorrow morning we will discuss detail parliament and parliament under parliament, Lok Sabha, president, Rajya Sabha, okay? So this thing we will discuss tomorrow. So let's move to the next question now. Kumi is the famous Asian dance form of which of the following state? Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and West Bengal, okay? So basically Kumi is a dance, Asian dance I can say, is from Tamil Nadu again, okay? So answer is your B. Now see, this is basically your folk dance, okay? Now dance, very important topic, and on this also in the GK dance class we will discuss all the things in the detail, okay? What is folk dance, what is classical dance, how to remember, and which are the important dance you should remember state wise, okay? So in that also I have a proper trick for you, so with that you can remember that, okay? So now let's discuss the folk dances of Tamil Nadu, okay? So you have to write this list now with me one by one. So let's start. So first dance of Tamil Nadu is your Parai Attam. Parai Attam, okay? So basically this Attam is our keyword for this Tamil Nadu, okay, to remember. So let's see how we can remember this. Next is your Thapattam. Thapattam, okay. Next is your Kummi, obviously we are looking that Kummi. Then Kola Attam. Kol Attam, okay, so see Attam and Attam again. Then Kara Attam. Kara Attam, I guess it is Karaga, okay, Karaga. Karaga Attam, like this, okay, Karaga, or you can say Karak Attam. So coal, karak and parai. Okay, this you can remember like this. Then mile, attam. Okay, unfortunately you have to remember all this name because they can ask any dance. Okay, that's why you have to remember, though no it there is no option we have, because you know TCS, they are always ready to pareshan us, right? So that's why. Then next is your pampu attam, pampu. Okay, next is your teru kuttu. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, now mile attam, pampu attam. Okay, one more attam is there, oil. Okay, oil, yes, oil attam. Okay, so how many dances? Folk dances. Basically, this is the list of folk dances of Tamil Nadu. So you have to remember parai attam, kol attam, karag attam, mile attam, pampu attam, theru kuttu, oil attam, and tapattam. Okay, so parai attam or tapattam, it is the same name basically, it is the second name you can say for this. So this is your folk dances of Tamil Nadu, you have to remember. So see, now I always choose grouping technique, okay, to remember. At least it works 80%, 90%. So see, attam is, I already told you, is the keyword. So all the attam collect together in your notes, write like this. First write all the attams, that is parai attam, kol attam, karag attam, mile attam, then pampu attam, then oil attam. Okay, and then in the second group, kummi, then teru kuttu, right? Two was there, yes. So one group of attam and one group of kummi and teru kuttu. Okay, like this you have to remember. Just 3 to 4 times revise this, okay, frequently, because I already told you that when we don't have gender awareness class, okay, as it is scheduled on alternate day, and soon I am trying that this will be a regular class, but you have to revise your notes again and again, because this is the most important questions we are dealing with, right? So nothing else, just don't read anything, but this you should revise 3 4 times, okay, compulsory. There is no option in that. So yeah, this is the discussion, enough for your dance. So this is the blank screen I left for that. Okay, next question. Which pollutant gas dissolves with hemoglobin faster than oxygen? Carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitric oxide and hydrogen sulfide. So basically the answer for is your carbon monoxide, okay, which is also called silent killer. Okay, now we will see. First, what happens? Suppose you go somewhere, okay, and there is carbon monoxide, then through your nose you will inhale that, okay, you will inhale that carbon monoxide, then it will go to our lungs where oxygen and carbon dioxide gas exchange between them, right? We will discuss this also in science lecture, so don't worry about that. For now, just understand, you inhale the carbon monoxide, then it goes to our lungs where your oxygen and carbon dioxide, okay, exchange with each other. Now what happens that, okay, carbon monoxide is very dangerous gas, that it does not allow it exchange between the this, okay? So that's why instead of oxygen, because you know that we take oxygen and leave carbon dioxide, but here what is happening, it blocks the oxygen, okay, in the simple language, just understood this, it blocks the oxygen, and our RBC, that is red blood cell, so red blood cell, okay, which have one protein named hemoglobin. So this is also very important question for you. So RBC, red blood cell, okay, there are two RBC and white blood cell also there. So hemoglobin, this is the protein basically, okay, and work of hemoglobin is to provide oxygen, or is to supply oxygen to our whole body, okay, your each body part, your each organ, your each cell, I can say. So it provide oxygen to your each cell, okay, whatever we are discussing, just write this, because every point is important, okay. They can frame any question from this, because this is the process that we are inhaling, then what is happening in between our body, right? That's why. So now the thing is that your hemoglobin is not carrying oxygen, basically it carrying carbon monoxide, which is very dangerous, and slowly carbon monoxide reaching to our body part, okay, and it will damage the body part, and then we may die, okay, we can die because there are high chances if the carbon monoxide level is high in that particular area where you inhale that, then yes, you can die, okay, because all the organs and brain, heart directly fail because this is very dangerous gas, okay, carbon monoxide. So that because of this, it is called silent killer, okay, or also it is called white damp. White damp, okay. And also one important point, that the molecules of carbon monoxide are quickly bind with the hemoglobin, okay. So, and the term for this is high affinity. So carbon monoxide is have high affinity, okay. Carbon monoxide have high affinity, because of which high affinity than oxygen, because of this it replaces the oxygen and hemoglobin carries the carbon monoxide and it supplies to our body, okay. So this is the basically one reason. So yeah, that's why our question was faster dissolved with hemoglobin, right, because of high affinity, and carbon monoxide is the perfect answer, okay. So just remember this process like this only, you can like this also, you can write in your notes basically, okay. So like this, this is called basically short notes, okay. In the exam, during the before the exam or in the last week, you should read that this notes only like that, okay. So important thing is that red blood cell, okay, it have hemoglobin protein, and hemoglobin supplies the oxygen to our body part, important part. And carbon monoxide is having high affinity, that is quickly binding power of molecules, okay. Molecules are the smallest part, right? So quickly they bind with hemoglobin than oxygen. So before you can also understand, like before oxygen combined with hemoglobin, okay, or hemoglobin, suppose it is ambulance, it is also called ambulance, right? RBC is also called ambulance because of this. So in the ambulance, instead of oxygen, carbon monoxide sits and it goes to our body part like this, okay. So that's why this is very dangerous gas, so be alert with this gas, okay. So yes, this is discussion enough for this question from science, or particularly we say biology. So yes, 8th question, which of the following country hosted the BRICS summit 2019? Now see, now what is going on 2020, but still they will ask you 2019, okay. That's why it is very important to have track of previous year and next year, okay. So Brazil, India, China and Russia. So the correct answer for this is Brazil, okay. So Brazil is your correct answer. Now we will see here BRICS, okay. Just we will see this name BRICS. So basically the full form is very important for BRICS. So this is B means Brazil, okay. Just write like this also only. R is your Russia, I is India, C is China, and your S is what? South Africa, okay. So basically BRICS is a group of BRICS is a group of 5 countries: Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, okay. First thing, very important. Then in 2019, as I told earlier, that the BRICS summit was in Brazil, okay. The first BRICS summit which you should know, it's happened for 2009, okay. It is 2009 first BRICS summit, okay. And this session what it is not given, okay. So this session of 2019 was 11th session which conducted in Brazil, okay. First in 2009, okay, in 2019 first 11th session in Brazil. Now the important thing is that the 12th session, that is 2020, it happens in Russia. Where? Russia. So now, till now it is very easy, right? See, Russia 2020, Brazil 2019, okay, based on name. And important point, in India 2021, which is your 13th session, okay. So see, very important to remember, right? Very important to remember. Just 1 minute, okay. See, so in Brazil 2019, okay, then Russia 2020, India 2021, okay. Write like this, So it is very important, very easy to remember. In Brazil, how much? 2019, 11th session. Okay. In Russia, 12th. And in India, 13th. Okay. And then first session, 2009. Easy. So like this. See. Easy na to remember. So this is the trick to remember for this question. Okay. So just remember this. And yes, Brazil. Okay, that's enough. This discussion is enough. So who is the current finance secretary? The next question, ninth question. Rajiv Gauba, Subhash Chandra Garg, Atanu Chakraborty and Rajiv Kumar. So what is the answer? Just tell me your answer. Ninth. So your answer is Rajiv Kumar. Okay. So Rajiv Kumar is your current finance secretary. Now, Rajiv Kumar is also your VP. Okay, vice president, or you can say vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Very important question, and you can say most expected question in your upcoming exams. So who is the vice chairman or vice president of Niti Aayog? Rajiv Kumar. Okay, who is also current finance secretary? Very important. So two posts basically. So current finance secretary also, and VP or VC of Niti Aayog. Okay, and Niti Aayog CEO, I will tell you that Amitabh Kant. This also you should remember, Amitabh Kant. Okay, so Niti Aayog, Amitabh Kant, and Rajiv Kumar. Okay, so yes, that's enough for this. So basically, if you remember in the yesterday's class, what we saw current revenue secretary. Okay, that Bhushan Pandey. So basically, revenue secretary, don't confuse with this, revenue secretary and finance secretary, both the terms for minister of finance only. Okay, and who is the our finance minister? Nirmala Sitharaman ji, right? So both the terms are under minister of finance, but revenue secretary is your Bhushan Pandey, that we saw in last class, and right, and finance secretary is your Rajiv Kumar. Okay, that is D. So yes, this is enough for this question. And the 10th and last question of today. From January 2020, banks can no longer charge saving bank account holders for online transaction in which of the following system? NEFT, IMPS, RTGS and IFSC. Okay, so your answer is NEFT. What? NEFT. So now you will, if you do transaction via from net, then obviously zero charges is there. Okay, so no problem. Now one by one we will see the full form. So NEFT. So what is the full form? Tell me. National Electronic. One minute. National Electronic Fund Transfer. Okay, F. National Electronic NEFT, transfer. Okay, all the full form are very very important. You can get any of this in your upcoming exam, so that's why write like this only. IMPS is your immediate payment system. It is your immediate payment system. You can pay just with the help of mobile number, right, which should be linked with your bank account. So immediate payment, immediate payment system. Then your RTGS is your real time gross settlement. Okay, any question you may get from this, so just be careful with the full forms. And last is your IFSC. So I hope you have IFSC, most of the students know, because this is related to banking. So Indian Financial System Code, okay, which is your IFSC. So the full form. Okay, now the question, what they may ask, what is the E in NEFT, what is the M in IMPS, what is the RTGS, okay, what is the T in RTGS. So like this you can expect the question for this topic. Okay, so this is the today's class for your general awareness. Now we will see summary of current affairs of today, that is 5th of December. So just give me 1 minute. Okay, so this is our current affairs. Okay, today's current affair from website. I hope you read already. So quickly, just in 2 minutes. Okay, just we will take 2 minutes to summarize. So see, first current affair, International Sand Art Festival and Konark Festival, very important for you. So you will write this. Okay, Konark Festival has kicked off in Odisha. It happens in Odisha. First important question. Then in Chandrapur Beach. Okay, this beach, Chandrabhaga Beach, very important. So where Chandrabhaga Beach located? In Odisha. Okay. This will they will not ask which district and all this thing. Okay, wait. Just Chandrabhaga Beach in Odisha, Konark Festival in Odisha. Okay, then okay, that's it for this current affair. Then next the festival again. Okay, it is the detail information related to festival. No need to write. Okay, now see, including Odissi, which is the dance of Odisha, Bharatanatyam. Okay. Manipuri, Manipur, Kuchipudi and Kathak. Okay, Kathak. So this is the classical dance carnival basically. Okay, this is the important point only. Okay, then obituary, Lakshadweep Hermit. Okay, don't write in your notes. Former PM of Pakistan, international current affairs. Okay, so don't write this also. Former French president Valéry Giscard. Okay, this is important. Okay, this is important that former president of France passed away and now the current president of France, okay, Vladimir Putin. Okay, so this is all about this. Then next page is there. Appointments. Okay, Kuldeep Handu appointed Fit India Movement Ambassador. Very important question for you. Fit India Movement Ambassador is Kuldeep Handu. Just remember this. Very important question. Okay, again I am telling. Just star mark this because I am sure that in the next your exam you will get this. Okay, then Fit India Movement was started in August 2019. Yes, they will ask this. Okay, so Fit India Movement, 2 points. Brand Ambassador Kuldeep Handu and started in August 2019. Okay, that's it for this. Then important dates. So 5th December, that is today, it was World Soil Day. Okay, and if there is a theme campaign, keep soil alive, protect soil biodiversity. Okay. So this thing you have to remember, just write in your notes. Then international day to celebrate soil. Okay, this thing is not important that much. Okay, so 5th December, World Soil Day, keep soil alive, protect soil biodiversity. Okay, then again International Volunteer Day. So today on the 5th December there are 2 days basically, soil and volunteer. So International Volunteer Day, also called International Volunteer Day for Economic and Social Development. Okay, and yes, team, very important team. Together we can through volunteering. So just remember or write in your notes. Okay, enough for this. Okay, then don't need this. Samvidhan Bhavan, India and UAE, USA signs MOU on intellectual property cooperation. So okay, write this, all these things. Okay, very important for you. All the full forms and all this there, because this current affair is very important. Next, Manipur's Nongpok Sekmai police station best in India. Okay, in the ranking to top list na Manipur. Okay, so you have to remember Manipur, also remember Tamil Nadu because they may ask you second also. Okay, so Tamil Nadu's which police station? AWPS Suramangal and Manipur Nongpok Sekmai. Okay, just remember this, nothing else from this. And okay, that's it. Okay, nothing else. And also don't remember or write this in your notes. Okay, HCS Roshni Nadal drops Kotak wealth Hurun wealthy woman list. Okay, so just write this also, not very important but still you can write because we don't know TCS mood for your day. Okay, and the last page, that is chairman of HCL Technology, Roshni Nadal Malhotra. A very important, who is the chairman of HCL Technology? Roshni Nadal Malhotra, because she is in the news. Okay, because she is in the top list of wealthiest women in India. You have to remember. Okay, then Kiran Majumdar Shaw of Bitcoin and Lina, also second and third. So first is HCL Technology chairperson, okay, Roshni. Second is your Kiran Majumdar and third is your Lina Gandhi. Okay, now very important is that. Okay, so you will write like this. And Bitcoin USD. Okay, so that's not important. Reliance Industries stock, Fortune India 500 ranking 2020. So top 10 companies on 2020 Fortune India 500 list. So just remember this, in the 2020 Fortune India 500 list, Reliance Industries topped, which Reliance obviously, right? So Reliance Industries topped there, and second is your IOCL, and third is your ONGC. Okay, so Reliance, IOCL, ONGC. Okay, that's it. So this is the overall summary of current affair. So just comment down below, you like it or not, or you don't want this. Okay, so we will skip, we will not doing, but I guess it will helpful for you. Okay, at least to summarize your notes for 5th December current affairs, because you know that current affair is very important. And you can do like this also, okay, in the morning or in the noon, basically in the noon it will update. Just write current affair, all the current affairs, and in night in our this class we will again summarize it. Okay, so it is a quick revision for you for the today's current affair. So basically you are looking it at twice. Okay, so yeah, that's it for the today's class. Just like the video compulsory, and any query, any doubt you have, okay, any point you think it is not clear, comment down below. I will again take that point in the next class. Okay, that is your third class. Okay, then take care, properly revise the things, because and sleep properly. Okay, so we will meet tomorrow hopefully, and tomorrow GK class is there. Okay, GK polity, parliament, very important class is there. In the morning I will upload, and then in your respective playlist I will update. Okay, all the best and good night.